In this video, I am going to explain functional relationship between scapular movement and shoulder movement. You know, shoulder is very movable joint. You can move shoulder for many direction. But when you raise up shoulder 180 degrees, this 180 degrees is not accomplished only by shoulder joint. What does it mean? This 180 degrees doesn't happen only in shoulder. Scapula needs to assist this 180 degrees somehow. So, if you want to accomplish 180 degrees, you need to be able to move scapula and shoulder joint. So this kind of relationship is called scapulohumeral rhythm. Scapulohumeral rhythm, okay? Scapula and humeral rhythm. This relationship is very, very important to understand shoulder mechanics. There is ratio in scapulohumeral rhythm. So movement of shoulder is 2. Movement of scapula is 1. Ratio is 2:1. Shoulder is 2. Scapula is 1. So that means when you want to move shoulder joint 180 degrees abduction, now 180 and ratio is 2:1, shoulder joint needs to move 120 degrees and scapula needs to move 60 degrees. So 120 to 60 is 2:1, right? So scapula needs to move 60 degrees. Shoulder joint needs to move 120 degrees, 2:1. Simple, right? By the way, what kind of movement is this? This is upward rotation for scapula. Upward rotation. Upward rotation is crucial for shoulder movement. Let's think about different number. What if you want to move shoulder 120 degrees? Ratio is 2:1. So shoulder needs to move 80 degrees. Scapula needs to move 40 degrees. This is 2:1, right? 80 plus 40 is 120. Simple, right? How about 90 degrees? Ratio is 2:1, so this should be 60 degrees for shoulder and 30 degrees for scapula. Do you see this relationship? Scapula needs to do upward rotation to assist shoulder movement. What kind of things inhibit movement of scapula and shoulder? Let's look at this muscle. This is rhomboid. Rhomboid. One of functions of rhomboid is downward rotation. Downward rotation. Remember, you need to do upward rotation for shoulder abduction. Function of rhomboid is downward rotation. What happens if your rhomboid is very, very tight? Scapula is stabilized at downward rotation position. Now, you can't do upward rotation very appropriately, right? Because now your scapula is stabilized in downward rotation. You can't do upward rotation. Now, what's going to happen? You can't move your shoulder joint as much as you could, right? That is why movement of rhomboid is very important. How about other muscles, like this one? This is levator scapula. This muscle also does downward rotation. If you go anterior part of chest, there is pectoralis minor, pec minor. This muscle also can do downward rotation. So if pec minor gets tight, that stabilizes scapula for downward rotation position. When these kind of muscles get tight, that can indirectly inhibit movement of shoulder joint. Does it make sense? So these muscles which attach on scapula is so important. Let's think about other muscles such as serratus anterior. Function of serratus anterior is actually upward rotation. When this muscle gets tight, that can also inhibit movement of abduction. You know, this sounds a little bit weird, but think about, let's say, biceps brachii. Function of biceps brachii is elbow flexion. When biceps gets tight, you actually can't flex your elbow appropriately, right? Because your biceps is too tight. That means biceps cannot do its function very properly, right? You can say same thing for serratus anterior. Main function is upward rotation. When this muscle gets tight, that also can inhibit upward rotation. This can lead to dysfunction of shoulder movement. Again, I explained the functional relationship between scapula and shoulder. There's a ratio 2 for shoulder movement, 1 for scapula movement. This functional relationship is scapulohumeral rhythm. This is crucial for understanding for shoulder mechanics. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.